So today I want to talk a little bit about using percentages versus pixels. Using percentages is one of the first steps towards getting your site to be responsive. It doesn't require a lot of media queries or anything else, and some of the responsiveness is built in. So why do we want to use percentages versus pixels? Well, pixels are constant. They're hard value. If I give something a width of 1200 pixels, like this, it's always going to be 1200 pixels. It's never going to change. It's going to take up 1200 pixels of room, whether it's on a desktop or it's on a phone. Percentage is a variable. It's based on whatever's holding it. In this case, it's the browser window. So it will shrink right along with the browser window. You can see as I shrink this window up, this element stays at 95%, but our 1200 pixel is still 1200 pixels, and that's how we get the horizontal scroll bar. So using percentages is one of the first things, but we also have to think about what's containing it. So right here on this small window, this small little area, these are pretty relatively close. 1200 pixels, 95%. But let's take a look on a wider area. Now you can see 1200 is a lot smaller than 95%. So when we're actually working with comps that are based on a grid, we have a problem with just using percentage because we're going to run into something like this. So that's when we use something called max width. So we're going to use a combination of the width, and we're going to use something called max width. Max width is going to limit the maximum width. So essentially what we're going to say is, hey, this block element should be 95% of the screen or the containing element, unless 95% is more than our max width, and then we're going to stop. So for example, I'm going to come right down here and I'm going to type in max width, 1200 pixels. Now you'll see here, it's still showing 95% and it's shrinking right along with things. But when you come over here, now they're both exactly the same. No matter how wide this is, no matter how wide the screen is, it's going to stop at 1200 pixels. Because again, we're saying the width is 95% unless it goes past 1200 pixels. Now when I shrink this screen, it'll stay 1200 until it hits 1200 and then it'll start shrinking. So at 1199 pixels, it now moves to 95%. So you can see the 1200 is still 1200, but our block element of 95% is 95%. So the next question becomes, how do we figure out what is our percentage based? Well, for that, we're going to come right over here and we're going to look at this comp. Now you can see that this comp has a full width of 1400 pixels. Remember, the full width stands in for 100%. It's the browser window, right? So even though we're only showing 1400 pixel, it's 100% of whatever the browser window is. Then we have a grid width. In this case, our width of our grid is 1200 pixels. Now there are varying grids out there. People may use their own grids. There's a 960 grid. Whatever your grid width is on your comp is how we're going to come up with the percentage. So there's a little formula here. You're going to take the total width of the grid, divide it by the total width of the comp, and you're going to come up with your percentage. So if we want to use percentages when we are coding this out, our total width of our page is 100%. That is 100% of the browser. And our container, which is represented by our grid, is going to be 85.7% with a max width of 1200 pixels. So you would come over here. We're going to change this to 85.7. And yes, you can use decimal points when you're using percentages. Pixels cannot be anything but whole numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Percentages don't have to be. So you can see again, here it shrinks down. Let's look at our live view. And again, 1200 pixels, it's holding that on until we get to a certain point. And then you can see it's 85%. Okay. So again, the math is just take whatever your grid is, whatever your total comp is, whatever your grid is, and then figure out the percentage, the ratio of container to whole screen, and set them up in your elements here, and boom, there you go. You now have percentages that you can use. These can be used on anything. If you have two divs that are inside there, and you want them to be 50% each, they'll be 50% of the holding div, so they will shrink as well. Percentages are the way to go. That's not to say we won't use hard pixels. We're definitely using hard pixel values on the max width. We'll definitely be using hard pixels if we need to force a height on something in a lot of cases. But overall, we want to try to avoid hard pixels as much as possible. You can even use percentages in your margin and your padding as well. So, first step of doing responsive is make sure that you are using percentage values as often as possible.